If more information was the answer, everybody would be billionaires with perfect abs. What do you think about this quote? Well, I think one of the biggest lies that I tell myself is that I'm missing one piece of information to get where I want to be. Let's say I want to get in shape. I want to build muscle. I want to lose fat. I sometimes lie to myself that another video on YouTube with a new idea about a new diet or a new research, this is what I need to get where I want to be. And in fact, I know the principles. You want to get bigger muscles. You need to work on the muscles. Yes, it's not about the new secret. You actually need to work on your muscle. You can do the exercises. You can't read about push-ups. You actually need to do them. So you might don't do them perfectly, but you're actually starting the process. So if more information was the answer, everybody would be billionaires with perfect abs. We have the information. The books are out there. Yes, read the book. But I think the key thing is to understand what's the ratio between execution and information. How many books should you read before you start executing? Maybe it's a good idea to start reading, and while you're reading the book, you can start applying the information and actually do things. So you can read the book about nutrition, so you can read the book about exercise or creating a business. So whilst you're reading the book, you can start doing something, execution, working on your skills, because knowing is not enough. We must do, we must apply, actually acquire the skills. So we can read about how amazing it is to have second language, but if we don't start learning a new language, is it helpful? Is it meaningful that we know that it can be good? We don't get the benefits because we don't learn. We don't put in the effort. And for me, it's about two parts within me. I have the analyzer, the part within me that is interested, he's curious, he wants to understand things, he wants to read. He wants to watch more videos. He wants to understand the bigger picture and all the ways and all the tactics and all the, this is the analyzer. And on the other hand, I have the soldier. He just wants to execute. He's in the doing business. He wants to execute, execute, execute. All he asks is, what can I practice? Give me something. What's the routine? What can I do every single day? And the soldier moves towards commitment. He wants to be committed to something. Give me something to do, I'll do it every single day, and that's it. He knows that this is good. He knows, he believes, he has trust that this is the way you need to execute. And the analyzer is also good. This part of me that is curious, he wants to understand things, he wants to understand the tactics, he likes to consume information, analyze, figure things out. He's also beneficial to me. So I don't say he's not important, but I do use my priorities. Commitment for me is number two. Number two in my overall values and priority. And the analyze, which represents being curious, he's moving towards attaining information, understanding, sometimes even having certainty. It's helpful for me, it's important for me, but not as commitment. So this is the thing. Coming back to the quote, if more information was the solution, everybody would be billionaires with perfect abs. This is what the analyzer is missing, because this is what he does. He likes to analyze. He likes to understand things and go into the details, consume more information. So he likes the theory, which can be helpful, but you need to put the theory into practice. This is where the soldier, he's just into the doing. He's in the action business, doing business. He always asks, what can I do? What can I practice? Give me something to do. He's always like, okay, practice something, something, give me. And my conclusion here is information is valuable. I'm not saying don't read the books. I'm not saying don't watch the videos. But what is the ratio between learning, consuming information, and applying? What's the ratio here? So I would go with 10% learning, analyzing, understanding, planning, but then you go ahead and you do 90% apply whatever you learned. 90% of the time, you are there in the soldier mode, executing, doing. And by the way, this doesn't mean that you don't go back into the planning. Yeah, because when you execute, you get feedback, and then you plan, you ask some questions, then you So you switch back and forth between the two. But overall, I would put 90% on the execution. Yes, 90% of the execution, 10% of analyzing, planning, thinking. This is it. Two cultures, the soldier and the analyzer.